Guess who's back? Back again. Yes, it's me. I'm back.
Yes, I'm back. I'm back again. What?
And if you thought you got rid of me, it wasn't going to be that easy. And now Triple G's back.
Ready to overload YouTube again with tons of awkward nerdiness that only I can provide.
But you gotta ease back into it after you've been out for so long. Let's go ahead and kick this off, right? Now. Now. What have I missed? When was July? 6-7 months ago? You know, you miss 7 months of entertainment, you are completely lost. So that's okay. Let's take a second right now to think about everything that's come out. I missed a lot. Yeah, life happens. So now I guess we're just gonna do some like quick hits about things that I've missed. Maybe give a little take on it and see where you rank your opinions on stuff. This is how I'd usually probably fight. Let's get it going, huh? Awesome. Totally better than the origin story, and actually has done wonders for the Wolverine character since X-Men 2. Hugh Jackman owns it. The third in the Simon Pegg, Nick Frost, Edgar Wright trilogy. It's pretty good. It's pretty funny. It's got some good funny moments. Martin Freeman's in it too. Maybe the weakest of the three, in my opinion. But, that's just an opinion. I still enjoy it. Just bloody goodness. Carl Urban's always awesome. And I enjoyed this movie. Glad with a chance at Meatballs 2. Fantastic. If you saw the first one, it's about the same humor, the same heart. So, it's wonderful. I enjoyed it. I saw it twice in the theaters, and not just because my daughter loves it too, but because I enjoyed it. Best game of the year, right? GTA Online's fun. GTA Online is fun. Sure, it gets a bunch of Game of the Year nominations, so at least it provided me with a lot of entertainment. Warner Brothers didn't completely ruin the Arkham franchise, but just kind of feels like a $60 DLC, which it's got some good moments, some good geek out stuff. And it's solid. I just can't wait for Rocksteady's next installment. Kind of more of the same from WWE 13, Take Two, 2K Games. Tackles it, but it was pretty much already done by THQ. It'll be more interesting to see what happens for 2K15. The best real-to-life zombie experience I've played. It's RPG. Put you in a lot of different situations. It kind of gets, repetitive after a while, but it was really fun. And for like 15, no, 20 bucks. For 20 bucks, it's kind of a steal. So Telltale offered up episodes 1 of 2 different games this year, and has yet to follow up with either one of them. Wolf Among Us came out in like September and was awesome, but they haven't followed up and actually released episode 1 of season 2 of The Walking Dead before they've even put out episode 2 of Wolf. So, kind of like putting a whole bunch of balls up in the air at one time. But, I enjoyed both of them. Telltale, solid. So, love them. Guess who's back? Anybody who heard Recovery knows that Eminem finally got some maturity in his lyrics and has kind of grown into the best rapper of all time. Marshall Mathers LP2 kind of brings back that twistedness of his old days, but with that maturity. So this album is stellar. Definitely go get it. Alter Bridge's fourth album, Fortress, brings you some more awesome rock from Miles Kennedy and Creed Company. I enjoyed this album quite a bit. It still kind of falls short to Blackbird, but I enjoyed it more than AB3, so I really, really like it. The Wrong Side of Heaven and The Righteous Side of Hell, Volumes 1 and 2, both came out this year. Five Finger Death Punch, you know, they're what they are. If you listen to them, you know what to expect. There's not a lot of change. Volume 2, kinda, meh. I just listened to it the entire way through last night, and it's kind of more of the same from Volume 1. Listen to it, but it might be one you could skip out on. Mid-season finale of Season 4 of The Walking Dead. Actually, every episode this season so far has been phenomenal, so when it comes back February 9th, happy birthday to me. It'll be interesting to see where they go, you know. Don't look back. Bittersweet season for How I Met Your Mother fans. They are ending this year. May will be the final episode of that series. And for those of us who have been watching, you know, every single episode since season one, it's definitely going to be intense. Part of me is ready for it to end, the other part is not, because, you know, it's off TV.
Bam! That was episode 15, all up in your face. Thank you for watching, thank you for supporting. It was 7 months between episode 14 and 15, and a lot of that had to do with me just being absolutely exhausted from life stuff. So a lot of you still like the page, and a lot of you still watch my old stuff, so thank you for that, and for being my motivation to keep doing this. We should be back on track, and I hope you stay with me, because episode 16, you know, I'm hoping will not be June or October. Thank you, everybody. Have a fantastic rest of your week. Take care. Peace.